My inspirations are life in general. I don't think that you can get a bigger inspiration than that. It kind of covers every single thing you might want to talk about. I mean, it can. I was looking through some old poems that I wrote on my phone on the way here, and there was stuff from just someone winking at me on the tube, which I found weird, and then asked myself, why is it weird for someone to wink at you? Why do we wink? to kind of past relationships, past friendships, to the universe. Like, literally, inspiration is everywhere. It was a performance poetry workshop, and I'd never heard of performance poetry, and I was extremely skeptical, and I thought, what on earth is this gonna be? And then I saw Joe Coelho and Dean Atta perform, and they were leading the workshop, and literally I sat there probably with my mouth open, in complete and utter awe. I was just like, I want to do this, I can do this, I'm going to do it. And literally those three things went through my head. I was just there like, cool, I can do this. There's nothing worse than forcing writing. I don't believe in forcing writing. I guess you could say I'm quite a selfish writer. I write to vent what I feel, because I think that the only voice that I've got is my own. I personally think that spoken word is mainstream. I mean, you watch the TV and you see the adverts and boom, there's a poem in the advert and you don't even realise. People like watching it and are intrigued by it and are stimulated by it and aroused and kind of gets under your skin in a way yeah. that poetry can't. Comedy kind of bounces off you in humour. Singing, it's amazing. I mean, I'm constantly listening to songs and music, but there's something about hearing someone's spoken voice just saying what they feel or how they've seen something and how they see it, and being able to create those images in your head. There's something really powerful and unique about that.